Do you want to completely ruin your computer? Well, of course not, which is why I'm gonna tell you the best ways you can do just that so you can avoid it. So in this video, I've got 7 dumb mistakes that could potentially destroy your computer hardware-wise permanently, or at the very least, your current OS installation. Of course, before we get started, don't forget to check out my amazing Instagram account where I post world-class tech memes from the highest quality sources. I mean, you'll probably die of laughter if you go on there. So just follow me over there. It's @TheoJoe on Instagram. And be sure to subscribe to this channel right here too, because I usually post new videos about twice a week and the YouTube algorithm might not recommend it if you're not subscribed. But anyway, let's get started. So first up, one of the surefire ways to damage your computer is improperly overclocking your CPU. Usually you want to slowly increase the clock speeds and voltages by small amounts, then stress testing your computer for stability. But if you go too far and just bump up the voltage way too high, you could immediately fry your CPU. If you want to overclock your processor, unless you really know what you're doing, the best thing you could probably do is just finding an overclocking guide for your specific CPU made by someone else who already did most of the testing for you, and then don't stray too far from their results. For example, back when I built my PC, I had an Intel 5960X CPU on a Rampage motherboard from ASUS ROG, and ROG is the brand from ASUS, and they actually released a guide specifically for my CPU on how to overclock it, and their guide showed what you could expect from a good result, an average result, and a fair result. So I was literally able to just look on there and say, okay, well, I'll try the average result, put it at that clock and that voltage, and it seemed to work out. So you might not get something as well clear cut as that, but that's what you can hopefully look for, and then you at least have a place to start. Now, one interesting thing to know if you're worried about overclocking is that Intel actually offers a kind of insurance called the Performance Tuning Protection Plan in the case the CPU fails because of overclocking, which might be worth looking into to see if it's worth it. I don't think AMD offers anything like this for CPUs though, but Intel, at least if you do have one of their CPUs and you're worried about frying it, this could potentially offer some protection against that. And it's really not even that expensive. It's like $20 or $30, I think, per CPU, and it covers it for a couple years. Just make sure you read the fine print and know exactly what's covered. I believe like bent pins probably would not be covered. It's only things resulting from overclocking. All right, the next thing that can damage your computer is having poor ventilation and cooling in your PC case. If you bought a pre-built system, it's probably okay from the manufacturer, unless there's a ton of dust buildup over the years or something. But if you have a custom-built computer, obviously you need to make sure your components are properly cooled, even if you're not overclocking. Basically, this means if you are overclocking the computer at all, you will want a heatsink better than the stock one, and make sure to have at least one intake and exhaust fan for air circulation. This is something that won't cause your computer to burst into flames or fry components the minute you turn it on because one of the fans is running slow. The CPU and graphics cards will throttle themselves, but over time, their lifespan will be reduced, including that of other components like hard drives. Of course, this isn't something that has to be super finely controlled. As long as you have reasonable circulation, it's very unlikely that your computer will die. It's more like just increasing the risk over time with increased temperatures. Okay, mistake number 3 is not using an uninterruptible power supply or UPS, or at the very least a surge protector. This one is pretty self-explanatory, but really important. Power surges can easily destroy a computer, and while they might be rare, why take the chance? Surge protectors are really not that expensive. Even better is getting an uninterruptible power supply, a UPS. This is basically a battery backup unit for a desktop computer that will keep your computer running for a short time if the power goes out or becomes unstable. These aren't meant to keep your computer running for hours, usually just a couple minutes, depending on how much power your computer draws. It may only do like less than a minute, maybe a couple minutes, so you have just enough time to save your work and shut down properly. They aren't too expensive either. You can get a decent smaller one from APC, is one of the manufacturers, for like under $100, or you can really go crazy and get some bigger ones. It's definitely worth the price and peace of mind, I think. It saved me several times where the power has gone out, and then really all it takes is like less than 30 seconds, like I said, to just say, okay, the power's out, time to turn off the computer, shut down, and then nothing's gonna get corrupted, or you're not gonna lose any data. You can do it really quick. Up next, one thing you should obviously never do is delete any system files. Most of the time, the operating system will make it impossible to accidentally delete anything critically important unless you really go out of your way to do it on purpose, but I have experimented in the past to see what happens if you delete some critical files just for fun, and no surprise, it immediately kills Windows and makes it so you will have to reinstall it completely. And by the way, if you want to check out that video of me deleting the infamous System32 folder, I'll have that link pop out at the top and probably put it at the end of the video too. The somewhat good news is that even if you somehow, for whatever reason, delete system files on your computer and ruin the OS installation, it's not like the computer is physically ruined. Your files are still on the hard drive and you can always reinstall Windows. It would just be a real pain and should obviously be avoided at all costs. Okay, on to number 5. This is something that actually sometimes happens and it's not even our fault, which is restarting or cutting the power to the computer or any other device really while it's updating. You surely have seen during literally any update ever, the computer will say something like, "Do not restart while updating," and you maybe wondered what would happen if you actually did that. Well, it turns out, in most cases, it probably is not the end of the world, and Windows at least will be able to roll things back and just tell you something like Windows could not finish installing the updates. Microsoft and other companies surely know that there are occasional situations where the power might go out during an update or an update might encounter an error, and likely has put in a lot of time into making sure stuff like that doesn't brick your computer. Of course, you still need to always avoid doing it because it is still very possible to corrupt certain files in a way that isn't recoverable, and again, you'd have to reinstall. But also, there are some situations like when updating the motherboard BIOS where it is absolutely imperative that you don't interrupt it because then you could literally brick the motherboard and then you really are screwed. All right, moving on. One thing to definitely avoid is shaking your hard drive while it's running. This really just applies to laptops and is something you don't need to worry about with SSDs, but it should be obvious why shaking a delicate piece of hardware spinning at 7200 RPM might be a bit risky. Now, most modern drives do have the ability to detect vibrations and will actually lock themselves down to try and prevent damage, so they aren't as sensitive as you might think, but it's still important to avoid it because you don't know what kind of long-term issues it might cause, and if it is extreme enough in the right direction, it might cause a platter to scrape against the case of the hard drive, for example. This is actually another experiment I did myself in a video where I literally put a hard drive on a laboratory vortexer to shake it violently while it was running, and actually it didn't kill it, but it did freeze up every time it was shaking, probably because of the drive's protection features. Still, doing this regularly would definitely damage it, and I wouldn't dare use this particular drive I used for the experiment after putting it through that. All right, we're on to the final mistake you should seriously avoid, but afterwards we can mention some other ridiculous ways to ruin your computer just for fun. So number 7 is something I am actually guilty of, which is messing around with the components inside your computer while it's running. You can risk things like accidentally shorting things out, hitting fan blades, and God knows what else. And my personal story with this is really embarrassing but funny. So one day I was adding a new fan controller inside my computer, and for some reason the fans attached to the water cooler unit weren't running. It was one of those all-in-one units with the radiators and some plugs to power the fans. Now, me thinking I was so smart, decided to get out my multimeter and use it to test if there was any actual voltage being applied to the fan pins, to tell whether the fan itself was dead or if they just weren't being powered. So I go and touch the multimeter probes to the pins on the water cooler unit while the computer was running, and I immediately hear a pop, and the computer just shuts down instantly, and I clearly shorted something out. And my initial reaction was basically just to stare at it, and I literally thought I fried the whole thing and would need to rebuild a computer. It was a mess. So I pressed the power button, and everything turns on except the water cooler, which was clearly dead. Its light wasn't on and the pump wasn't running. So I ended up having to replace the water cooling unit, which was like $150, not cheap, but fortunately nothing else was shorted out, but could have been a lot worse. So learn from my mistake and don't go messing around with the inside of your computer while it's running. It's not worth it. All right, so those are some things you realistically need to avoid so your computer stays undestroyed, but what fun is that? In fact, there are plenty of ways people have actually come up with to actually try and destroy their computers for pure entertainment value. One example is the infamous Ether Killer device, where someone literally took an AC power cable and spliced it directly to an Ethernet cable. I'm not sure if this has ever actually been tested beyond being a meme, but it would at the very least destroy the network card or the motherboard it's plugged into. Now, I mentioned you need to keep your computer free of dust for adequate cooling, but one way to not do that is to wash your motherboard with soap and water. This has also been a meme for a while, and I even made a video of my own talking about this, but needless to say, liquid and computer components do not mix. In fact, one thing I could have added to the main list was to avoid spilling liquid on your laptop keyboard, because even if you dry it out, it might cause long-term corrosion damage that might not be immediately apparent. And definitely don't do what I did and pour an entire quart of motor oil into your PC. I mean, unless you really want to, I guess. I'm not your parents. You can do what you want. But regardless, now after this video, you should be statistically less likely to ruin your computer. Congratulations. Again, be sure to subscribe because I make multiple videos a week. And if you want to watch that video of me deleting System32 in Windows, I'll put that link right here. So thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.